When I started to create an alternative to the traditional bee smoker, I thought to myself, this will be easy. All it has to do is look like smoke. But that's not true. Bees don't really care what smoke looks like. They care what it smells like.
Fire!
They're very olfactory creatures, meaning that they respond to smells. All day long, they're responding to pheromones inside of the hive instead of sight because it's all dark in there. They live most of their lives in a dark environment where they use pheromones in order to communicate. Here's an example. There's a lot of smoke, but the bees don't react at all because the smell is wrong. One of the things that a traditional bee smoker does is it moves bees off of a frame in order for us to be able to work the frame. It's not the only thing that it does, but it's one of the factors that I really want to get right. The traditional smoker also calms bees by making them engorge and also by making them think that there's a fire. I'll talk more about the calming elements of it in another video. I've been working on a protocol that I call the frame return rate, and the point behind it is to see how quickly the bees return after smoking them back up to the frames. The idea is to make sure that it's very easy to be able to work the bees and get them out of the way. And again, this all depends on smells that push them down into the frames. Let's take a look at how the tests are going so far.
Okay, we're testing. I want you to count to four when you do it, ready?
One, on there. Two, three, four.
So see how well that worked?
It looks like we have a winner here. This is B4. Oh yeah, much better.
You can see here different samples, different formulations that we've used, and also the traditional bee smoker that's on here as a comparison. The beta tester takes a picture before they smoke the bees, right after they smoke the bees, and then 60 seconds and 90 seconds after they smoke the bees to see the progression of how quickly the bees come back up onto the frames. People sometimes ask me if we're testing also with mean bees or Africanized bees. The answer is yes, and here is a picture of a beekeeper in Texas who is working with some spicy bees. It's been really interesting to see how hot bees react versus gentle bees. The reaction to the frame return rate has been pretty similar, and we're also taking a look at how this is calming the bees. This testing is being done as a blind study. The reason I'm doing this is because I don't want them to, even at a subconscious level, be making decisions based on what I've told them is inside of this formulation or that formulation. I want them to make the determination solely based on how the bees react. Now, that being said, sometimes they can smell things like black licorice smells that I sometimes use, or lavender smells. In the end, it's unlikely that it's gonna smell like this or that. It's probably going to smell like a mix of different things that we put together. With each beta test, we're getting better and better at the frame return rate. And what's nice about it is it's very repeatable because we're using the same amount of smoke, the same amount of fan every time. One of the things that surprised me was with two different colonies, this one's the blue one and this one's the green one. You can see here that even with super experienced beekeepers like this one here, that the results of the traditional bee smoker differ greatly. You can see here after 60 seconds, that there's quite a difference here. With the green, you can see that the smoker did very well here, but didn't do very well here. I think this goes to show that sometimes the smoker has a lot of fuel in it, is doing really well, sometimes it's not. And so you have a lot of variation between what's going on with the smoker. Whereas you can see here with D3, we had a pretty similar response after 60 seconds. I think that comes down to the advantage of always having the same amount of smoke coming out, same amount of fan, and ending up with very similar results. I thought that this was an interesting, unexpected discovery. One of the things that really surprised me was how much variation there is in just using the typical traditional bee smoker. I think a lot of it has to do with how much you filled up the smoker, how hot it is at the time that you're using it, the fact that you're using bellows. Sometimes you press it all the way, sometimes you press it part of the way. There's a lot of different variation that happens with the amount of smoke that's coming out of this device at any given time. In comparison, we're pressing a button, and we're using the same amount of smoke, same amount of fan every time we press the button. It creates a much better consistency of the results that we see. We keep getting better and better at testing these different samples with the bees. I'll keep you updated as we learn more. Make sure that you sign up for the very important Beekeeper Club. There's absolutely no cost to it, and it's just to be able to keep up to date with everything that we're doing. It's just vib.technicallybeekeeping.com.